In today's video, we are going to be talking about metabolic syndrome, what it is, and five steps you can take to reverse it. Metabolic syndrome is characterized by five main components: a large waist circumference, high triglycerides, low HDL cholesterol, high blood pressure, and high fasting blood sugar. If you have three or more of these, you'll be diagnosed with metabolic syndrome. And having metabolic syndrome isn't just about your weight. It can increase your risk of several diseases as well. These include heart disease, fatty liver disease, type 2 diabetes, and PCOS in women, to name a few. But if you do have metabolic syndrome, not all hope is lost. It is possible to reverse the symptoms, improve your health, and reduce further disease risk. So in today's video, we are going to talk about what metabolic syndrome is and what causes it, and five steps you can take to reverse it. And these tips are not going to be the generic and extremely vague tips that we always hear about. These are going to be a lot more specific and actions that you can start implementing today. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name's Kate. I'm a health coach and I post videos on a high-fat, nutrient-dense way of eating. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, feel free to share, and make sure to subscribe. And make sure to follow me on Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook, where I share new posts every single day. The rate at which we see metabolic syndrome occurring is increasing, with more and more people being diagnosed every year. As I mentioned before, the recommendations we receive on how to deal with metabolic syndrome are extremely vague and not very helpful. We have all heard the classic, eat less and move more. But if it were really that simple, we would be seeing the rates of metabolic syndrome decrease and not increase. And a lot of people will say that it comes down to willpower. They will say that people are just lazy, that they don't follow their doctor's recommendations, and that is the problem. But here's the thing. The recommendations that most healthcare professionals are giving are setting people up for failure. You do not have to eat a severely calorie-restricted diet to reverse metabolic syndrome. You do not have to kill yourself every day at the gym either. There is a much simpler approach that leads to maintainable results. And we will get to that in just a minute. But first off, we are going to talk a little bit more about what causes metabolic syndrome, because the answer isn't as simple as you might think. What causes metabolic syndrome? As I said at the start, metabolic syndrome is characterized by five main components: a large waist circumference. For women, this is over 35 inches or 89 centimeters, and for men, this is over 40 inches or 102 centimeters. High triglycerides, over 150 milligrams per deciliter or 1.8 millimolars per liter. Low HDL cholesterol, less than 50 milligrams per deciliter or 1.3 millimolars per liter for women, and less than 40 milligrams per deciliter or 1 millimolar per liter for men. High blood pressure and high fasting blood sugar, over 100 milligrams per deciliter or 5.6 millimolars per liter. If you have three or more of these components, you have metabolic syndrome. But here's the thing, it's not just a coincidence that all of these conditions go hand in hand. There is something at the root which is causing them, and that something is insulin resistance. Metabolic syndrome actually used to be called insulin resistance syndrome. And the name insulin resistance syndrome is actually a lot more helpful because it tells us what's causing the symptoms. A large waist circumference means you have excess visceral fat, which is a type of fat stored within the abdominal cavity. This is well known to be directly caused by insulin resistance. In someone who is insulin resistant, fat is not being stored properly, so a lot ends up accumulating in the abdomen as visceral fat. High triglycerides and low HDL are also directly related to insulin resistance. When people reverse insulin resistance, their triglycerides go down and their HDL goes up. Blood pressure is the same thing. Over 90% of high blood pressure cases are caused by insulin resistance, and when the resistance is reversed, blood pressure returns to normal. And the final component of metabolic syndrome is high fasting blood sugar. Insulin is the hormone that is responsible for transporting glucose, or sugar, from our bloodstream to our cells. Now, when we are insulin resistant, our cells are not responding to insulin correctly, so they do not take in as much blood sugar as they should. And this eventually leads to high blood sugar. The point is that if you have metabolic syndrome, you are insulin resistant. And you might be thinking, oh great, now I have another problem to deal with. But the news that metabolic syndrome is insulin resistance should be empowering because it actually explains what the issue is. And even better news, insulin resistance is reversible. So now let's get into the 5 steps you can take to reverse metabolic syndrome. Number one, stop snacking. Every time we eat, the food is broken down by the body and blood sugar rises. And this rise in blood sugar triggers insulin to be released. Now, high insulin for a prolonged period of time is what leads to the resistance in the first place. So the lower we can keep insulin throughout the day, the more sensitive our cells will become to it again. If we are eating and snacking all day long, insulin is always high. Now, there are some healthcare professionals out there who will tell you that eating small, frequent meals throughout the day is the best approach to insulin resistance. And unfortunately, this is completely backwards. Eating 2 to 3 meals throughout the day and not snacking will mean that your insulin will have a chance to come back down to baseline in between meals. Number two, eat carbs last. Eating carbohydrate-rich foods at the end of your meal, after your protein and non-starchy vegetables, makes the insulin response a lot less dramatic. And again, the goal is to keep insulin low, to improve insulin sensitivity and reverse metabolic syndrome. One study that was done on type 2 diabetics had participants eat the same meal 3 days in a row. On the first day, they ate the carbohydrate portion of the meal first, and then 10 minutes later, the protein and vegetable portion. On the second day, they ate the protein and vegetables first, waited 10 minutes, and then ate the carbs. And on the final day, they ate everything together. Insulin levels were tested before eating and after eating every 30 minutes for the following 3 hours. The study found that insulin levels were significantly lower after the meal when the carbohydrate portion was eaten last. And again, keeping insulin low is the goal here, so this is a good thing. Number three, reduce carbs. Now, if you want to take this one step further and see faster results, reducing carbs entirely is the way to do this. Because carbohydrates are the macronutrient that raises insulin the most, much more so than fat or protein. So if you can limit your total carbohydrates for the day to 100 grams or even 50 grams, you are going to be significantly reducing your insulin load. Number four, get proper sleep. Sleep is so important for our metabolic health. And it's not just about how much sleep you get, but also about the quality and the timing. It has been well established that night shift workers are at an increased risk of developing metabolic syndrome. It is so important to be in sync with our circadian rhythm. We want to be awake during the day and asleep at night. Another thing to note is that even one night of poor sleep can make someone who is normally insulin sensitive temporarily insulin resistant the following day. A poor night's sleep also messes with our hunger hormones, including ghrelin and leptin, making you hungrier than you otherwise would be. Now, my best tip for getting your circadian rhythm in sync, and this won't come as a surprise if you've watched any of my other videos, is to wear blue light blocking glasses 2 to 3 hours before bed. These glasses block blue light, and blue light is a problem at night because it suppresses melatonin. Melatonin regulates our sleep-wake cycle and is released a few hours before bed, making us sleepy. However, blue light suppresses its release, making it difficult to fall asleep. And we are surrounded by blue light. It is emitted off our laptops, our cell phones, our house lights, and unfortunately, the blue light filters on our devices do not block enough of the blue light to make a difference. Wearing a pair of blue light blocking glasses like these ones from Blue Blocks can help to sync your circadian rhythm, improve your sleep, and reverse metabolic syndrome. You can check them out by going to healthcoachkate.com/blueblocks. And if you do decide to grab a pair, make sure to use code HCK15 to save 15% off your order. Number five, build muscle. Now, I really do think the diet is the most important factor when it comes to reversing metabolic syndrome, but exercise can help as well. But when I say exercise, I do not mean spending an hour a day running on the treadmill or doing one of those fitness classes at the gym that is only focused on keeping your heart rate high. I'll get to what types of exercise are best in a minute, But first, let's talk about why it helps, because it isn't just about burning calories. First off, exercise is beneficial for metabolic syndrome and insulin resistance because when you are exercising, your muscle cells are able to absorb glucose without insulin. And second off, if you have more muscle mass, this means your body can store more glucose. Now, in terms of the type of exercise you should be doing, resistance training has been shown to be more effective minute per minute than cardio, and this is also how you're going to build muscle. The most effective type of resistance training is up for debate, but training with either weights or body weight can both be effective when done correctly. And here's the best part. You do not need to spend hours or even 1 hour in the gym every day in order to get these results. Even 10 to 15 minutes of basic body weight movements, so squats, push-ups, planks, can yield some amazing results when it comes to insulin sensitivity. A 2019 study looked at the effect short-duration resistance training had on insulin sensitivity in overweight men. They did 3 resistance training sessions a week for 6 weeks, with each session only lasting 15 to 20 minutes. During the workout, they did 1 singular repetition of 9 different exercises at 80% of their 1 rep max. After 6 weeks, participants saw an increase in their insulin sensitivity. These men did 9 different exercises for 1 single rep and got results. Anyways, guys, that's all I have for you today. Let me know in the comment section down below if you have metabolic syndrome and if you knew that it was the same thing as insulin resistance. If you do like this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up. You can share it with a friend who you think would find it helpful and subscribe if you're not subscribed already. Thank you so much for watching. And if you did enjoy this video, you might also enjoy my video on the best low insulin foods that you can eat. You can find it right here. If you want to catch up on my most recent upload, you can find it here. And if you want to check out my keto diet and carnivore diet coaching programs, you can find those here. Thanks again, guys. I'll see you next time. Bye.